Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. All right, we're going to do this percent mixture problem using one variable. Mary has some 1% fat milk and some 4% fat milk and wants to make 15 cups of a 2% fat milk. For instance, the 1% is like the pretty super low fat, but not quite non-fat. The 4% is the regular milk. 2% is what they usually call the regular low fat milk. So let's see what's going on here. She's got some of the 1%, right? And she's mixing it with some of this 4% in this big vat. And she wants the final solution to only be 2% fat. So if you want, you could also write 1% fat. Just this is a way of labeling these so you can keep track. And this is the mix, right? She's going to mix these two together. Now, underneath each one, I'm going to write the percentage as a decimal. So 1%, remember, would be 0.01, 4% is 0.04, and 2% is 0.02. Remember, we always want to write our decimals as, I'm sorry, we want to write our percents as decimals. You could write them as fractions, but that makes it more complicated. So we'll write it as decimals. Now, notice that we're trying to get a 15 cups total in this 2% mixture. So what we know is there are going to be 15 cups of milk here. And I'm trying to find how many cups of each, the 1% and the 4%, to put in here. So let's say I said in the 1% fat, let's say we want X cups of milk, then what would go in here for the 4% fat? I know that X plus whatever's in here has to add up to 15. So if the total's 15 and I've already used X cups in the 1%, like if that was 2 cups, there would be 13 left here, right? How would I get that? I do the 15 minus the 2 cups to figure it out. But I don't have 15 cups, I have X cups. So I've got to do 15 minus X. That's what goes in here. Now, if you know how to do systems of equations with two variables, this problem could also be done with two variables, and I'll be doing that on another video, the same exact problem. But this is how you would do it if you only knew how to solve equations with one variable. So notice the amount in each vat here. I've got X cups plus I'm adding that to 15 minus X cups, and that does actually equal 15, right? If you did X plus 15 minus X, well, what do you get? You would get 15. So that does make sense, hopefully, to you. Now here's the idea. When you mix these two together, there's a certain amount of fat that's extracted from this first vat, and that is the percentage of fat of the total amount of cups here. And there's only 1% of that X is fat. So the actual fat in that vat is 1% of X. So in other words, if you extracted it down, and you were able to just get the fat in a cup, it would have 0.01x in there. Now the fat in here would be 4% of how many cups I have in this vat. So that would be 0.04 times 15 minus x. Remember to put a parentheses around it. So if you wanted to think of it as some stuff, you could put a box around it. You don't need to, right? And if you, in the mixture, we know that we want to get 2% of 15 cups. That's what we're trying to make. So in the mixture, there's 0.02 times 15. That's actual fat. Now, it doesn't look right with these boxes, but what it's saying is this fat right here and this fat right here, that fat's not going to disappear when you mix the two together. So this becomes an equation. The fat in these two separate containers is equal to the fat in that final container. I usually just write that without the boxes. 0.01x, the fat from the first container, plus the fat from the second container, is the same as the amount of fat in the final container. Now from here, there are various ways you could solve the problem. You can eliminate all the decimals by multiplying both sides of the equation by 100, or if you don't mind the decimals, you could work with the decimals all the way through the problem and use a calculator. I don't like using my calculator personally. I like to do as much as possible without getting my calculator out. So here's what I'm going to do. I notice that there are two decimal places, two digits after the decimal place in all of these. So if I multiply both sides of the equation, and the way I like to show that is just a big box, if I multiply the left and the right side by 100, then when I multiply each of these by 100, the decimal will move 2 to the right, and I'll get rid of all my decimals. So I have to distribute it to each term on both sides of the equation. And be careful with this second term here, by the way. You don't multiply the 0.04 by 100 and what's in the parentheses. It's one or the other. So we'll multiply the outside. So when I do 100 times 0.01, that just now becomes 1x or x. You could write 1x or you could write x. When I multiply it by the next term, remember this is the whole term, 0.04 times 15 minus x. Well, when you multiply three things together, you just first multiply two things together. So the 100 times 0.04 is just 4, and then I still have to multiply by 15 times x. Do not also multiply the inside by 100. And the last term, on the right side of the equation, when I multiply by 100, same thing, I'm just going to multiply the 100 times the 0.02. The idea is to get rid of the decimals, right? If possible. So that becomes 2 times 15. Now, if you had something like 2.5%, like 0.025, you would have to multiply by 1,000 and move all the decimals 3 to the right, right? The whole idea is I'm trying to eliminate the decimals. If you wrote these as fractions, you would multiply by 100 because you'd have 100 in the denominator. All right, so that's just a little discussion of fractions and decimals. All right, so now we have this equation without decimals, which I think is easier to solve. And I'm going to have to do my distributive property here, the 4 times 15 minus x. So I have 1x. Again, no need to write the 1 in front of it. And I'm going to distribute that 4. So 4 times 15 is 60. 4 times x is 4x, and I have a minus sign, so it's minus 4x equals 2 times 15 is 30. So we're going to combine like terms here, and at the same time, I'm going to go ahead and subtract 60 from both sides, so I have my variables on the left side and my constants on the right. So I have 1x minus 4x. Well, that's 1 plus negative 4, which is negative 3x, equals 30 minus 60 is, same as 30 plus negative 60, that's a negative 30. So now we could just divide both sides by negative 3. And x will be 10. All right, now we have to remember, what did x stand for? So let's go back up to our problem here. X stood for how many cups of the 1% fat I'm going to use. So I'm going to draw this picture again, and we're going to now put in 10 for x. All right, so here's how we started. And we have to remember what x stands for. X stood for how much of the 1% milk. So I'm going to put in 10 right here. Now remember we had 15 total, and these had to add up to 15. So if you've got 10 plus what would give you 15, we must be using 5 cups of the 4% milk. Now we're going to make sure that the fat all really is the same. All right, so how much fat is in this first vat? Well, now I know that I've got 10 cups, it's really 1% of 10. So 0.01 times 10, right? Okay, now what is that? What is 0.01 times 10? Well, that is 0.1. So it's really 1/10 of a cup of fat in all those 10 cups. All right, what about in this vat? I've got 5 times 0.04. And that's really the same thing as 0.2. So there's only 2/10 of a cup, I mean, of fat in those whole 5 cups. And what about here? We've got, in this vat, we've got 0.02 times 15. So 2% of 15, see, that's going to be 0.3. Now, by the way, this is how you multiply decimals if you forget. You just go ahead and do the 2 times 15, which is 30, and then you move the decimal place into, and that's how I got 0.3, right? Or you could just do that with your calculator. But now, the question is, you had 1/10 of a cup here, and you had 2/10 of a cup here, and you should have the same amount of fat at the end. So the question is this true? Yep. So I do have the same amount of fat in the mixture. So now what's the question? How many cups of each type should she use? Well, what worked out is to have 10 cups of the 1% fat milk and 5 cups of the 4% fat milk. And so that's how we want to write our final answer. So our final answer then, how many cups of each should she use, is right here. Use 10 cups of 1% fat milk and 5 cups of the 4% fat milk. That gives her this final solution, if you want to think of it, of the 2% milk.
Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.